Hey YouTube, Texas Slinger here. Wanted to show you my improvements on my Beretta 92 Compact. Do a safety check here. You can see there's nothing in there. One thing I did was I got these new grips here, and I swapped out the screws with these neat stainless ones right here. So, looks real nice. Quick little thing about this, I've shot it several times at the range. Got videos of me shooting it, if you'd like to check it out. I can do a quick takedown here, too, for any of y'all who are interested. There's a button right here. You want to press that and then slide that lever down, and then you're able to bring the top slide out right here, and all you do is just push that back right there, and then it comes out real nice right there. And then there's a little button here that you press, and you got to kind of wiggle the barrel out, but it comes out real nice. And just the same way you put it, took it out, just put it back in, and then you gotta wobble it a little for it to seat itself in there. We'll get it. This is no good right there. There you go. Just make sure this guy locks in place. You know he's not moving at all. And then take this guy, put him down there, and then he locks in behind that tab right there. And then it just slides right back in. So put him back about right there, and then slide that back up. Fire, double action, single action, and that's your safety decocker. Real nice. I love this gun. Real nice. I got that barrel polished compared to the rest of the finish here. And with the grips, it just looks really nice. And I'll introduce my 3-month acquisition, of my crossbreed holster. Took 3 months to get this thing after I ordered it there on, staying pretty busy over there. But as you can see, this is the crossbreed holster. It's got a nice, nice thick leather right there. I think this one's about a month old. And it goes in like that. Then what's really neat are these little washers. Find my these little washer screws, and they actually poke into the leather. They were starting to get loose, so I put some blue Loctite on them, and haven't had any problems since then. So pretty nice, real comfortable, real concealed. And this is the my magazine holster here. I've got the magazine for the Beretta 9mm. I make another one for a 40, and it's just a little bit looser, but this holds it real nice right there. And then that's my pepper spray. It tucks in real nice to any pants that I have. Any pants. So it's real nice. Notice it rusted right here. I carry this just about every day. Yeah, got some rust right there. This is my 30-round magazine. That's kind of badass right there. That's the OEM one that came with it. And these are the standard ones. That's a 15 round. It's a 13 round. And that's the 30 round right there. This is just a little quickie holster that I bought and I throw in the truck. Works pretty nice with it. It's made for a revolver. It's a Black Hawk size 2. While I'm at it, this is my XDS 45. Real neat little gun. So you can see they're both pretty concealable. Nice holsters. It's forget the name of this one. It'll come to me in a second. I believe it's Triple T. Triple T holsters out of Texas. I got it at the gun show here in Houston just a little while ago. But it's real nice. Right there. There. So if you want to get an idea, the bread is thicker because it's a double stack, but the XDS is a single stack, 45. See, the XDX tucks a lot better with a fraction of the weight, but I've got 26 to 28 rounds potentially out of this one, and the pepper spray, and I've got 6 rounds out of this one. Gotta make it count with that one. So again, it's a Lamo Camo from Hogue. It's really, really nice. All right, hope you enjoyed it. Check out my other videos. Thanks, guys.